Here's a look at my new home network rack setup, and I actually downsized a bit recently. I'll talk about that in a second. But what I have here at the top as the gateway, of course, here is my internet modem from Comcast Business, and then I've got right on top here is the UCG Fiber. And this I downsized from the Dream Machine Pro Max, which is a 1U device. I added in this extra shelf right here, and then I put in this device right here, which is the Pro XG8. It's a 10 gigabit switch, and I really don't have a ton of 10 gigabit devices, as you can see. I've only got three things plugged in here, and only two of them are actually active. And this replaced the Enterprise XG, which is a 24 port 10 gig switch. It was too many ports. I didn't need so many 10 gig ports. I certainly wasn't using all of them. And then down here, I have the Pro Max 16. And below that, we've got the UNVR as well as the RPS. Now the RPS, I almost pulled this out as well. It was plugged into the UNVR, the UDM Pro Max, as well as my Enterprise XG switch. And now it's just plugged into this UNVR, but I left it for the time being because it's a real pain in the butt to pull those thick cables out of the back of this RPS. They're totally a pain to work with. But the reason that I downsized these two pieces of equipment is basically for heat. Right here in the summer, this office gets so hot, like we're talking 80, 85 degrees because of the amount of equipment that I have running, and I really didn't need the UDM Pro Max because my internet connection is only about 800 megabits, so I don't need that much throughput going through the firewall. And then I don't have very many 10 gig ports, so I didn't need a full 1U Enterprise XG, 24 port switch. So this setup makes a lot more sense. It's also much less heat being pushed out the back of these devices. And the only thing that kind of annoys me is that the XG switch, you see I've got this blank plate right here. The 24 port Enterprise XG was in this spot right here. And so you see these cables that were going up used to go down out of this brush panel into the switch below. And now they have to hop across this 16 port switch, which kind of annoys me because this rack doesn't have any side cable management, but it's only a few cables, so I'm dealing with it. And the other thing that I might change is that right now I've got a DAC cable going from my gateway over to the 8 port 10 gig switch, and then a second DAC cable connecting over to the Pro Max 16. So I'm daisy chaining those two switches. And you guys tell me, do you think it's better to have the Pro XG8 be kind of a core switch that is fanning out to the other switch in a daisy chain, or should I run both switches directly off the gateway?